So you think that if it's in the preview...
If it's in the preview, it's not a spoiler. Because people... The movie... Whoever produced the movie has already decided to show that to people. They've already spoiled it, so we can't spoil something that's already been spoiled.
But don't you think it's more important, instead of me defining what I think a spoiler is and you defining what you think a spoiler is and then trying to come up with a compromise, don't you think we should go to some lengths to find out what the general consensus is on what is a spoiler and use that definition?
Yeah, but
because otherwise,
you don't think one of us is with the general consensus?
I think that the fact that I have read, not from like you or not from my mom, no one that I know wrote this. If this is an actual opinion from several people.
From what? Like some random website?
Yeah, a website that reviews
movies. Okay.
Okay.
You
and
read
they
what?
They say, and I don't remember it exactly, but I'm just going to, it says something like, you can say a lot about the first 30 minutes or the first 45. I think 45 is too long. But if something happens in the first 30 minutes, you can mention it in a review and it's not considered a spoiler because it happens so early in the movie. But once you reach a certain point in the movie, you can't reveal anything that happens after that. And I think that the people that...
Even if what you're mentioning is a plot point... has something to do with the plot.
I don't know that matters. Okay, say for example, in the movie Strangers. Remember the very beginning of the movie, they had that little thing that comes on the screen that says, we're making this movie based on what we know from the scene of the crime, no one really knows. They pretty much say, the opening scene of the movie, the first thing you see before you even see any characters,
And
they say, everybody pretty much dies in this movie. So you're saying that if that is not in the preview, that we can't say everybody dies?
Yeah.
Even though it happens in the opening scene?
Yeah.
I don't think that's a spoiler.
Why not?
What are you spoiling?
You're spoiling the movie for them.
So you're saying if they know that, they won't go see the movie?
Maybe
the movie has been ruined.
Yeah.
No,
I think that there's a lot of people that would think that.
Okay. If us saying it is going to ruin the movie, then the opening scene's going to ruin the movie. Us saying it won't change the fact that the movie's ruined, because it will be ruined when they see it on the screen.
Well, unless they're comfortable with it once they're sitting there.
What does it matter? If they're sitting there and they're reading it, it's the movie's ruined. If we've said it before they get to the theater, it's ruined. It's ruined either way.
Yeah, but we decided to ruin it, not the movie. The movie can ruin whatever it wants.
We haven't ruined it.
We've ruined it because it's not our place to ruin it as the reviewers.
I don't think so. And this is something else. A lot of people's opinion, everyone's opinion is going to be different on what a spoiler is. Everyone's. They're going to say, you spoiled it. We could go to extreme lengths to not spoil a movie by whatever definition we come up with, and someone out there is going to say, I can't believe you said that. You totally spoiled the movie. That's why I think we should find out what the definition is. The generally,
you already think you know what the definition is.
I think I do. But the generally accepted, but you don't believe me. So if we can find that somewhere, would you... If we could find that somewhere...
Well, who's writing it?
I don't know. What if it was Roger Ebert? Would that help?
No.
So who would it have to be for you to...
I don't know.
Doesn't matter who says it. You don't agree with it.
Well, I just know that so far, we've been doing a lot of reviews, and people think we're spoiling movies, and you don't. And I've mentioned a couple times, I think we've spoiled that movie. And you're like, no, we didn't. And other people are also bringing up the fact that we're spoiling things.
Okay. Well, a lot of other people...
There's a lot of other people out there thinking that we're spoiling
exactly.
movies.
Exactly. And we're not. And I think that's important.
Because happened in the first 30 minutes.
Yes. Or whatever the time is. Are you going to say, it doesn't matter if you think we spoiled it because we didn't?
Well, whether or not if we didn't spoil it.
But what if they think we did?
Well, it depends.
That's
on
what's going
it depends on
here.
Whether we did or not. Did we spoil
by
the movie
by whose definition?
Or not?
Theirs? Because if it's by their definition,
they got to give me a reason. How did I spoil it?
I think that you shouldn't have said this about that guy. You shouldn't have revealed that he's 42 when he's really 42. I wish you hadn't said that. I wish I could have learned that in the process.
That's not a major point of the plot.
So it does matter. So it doesn't matter what other people think.
No, as I said in the beginning, it matters if it's a major plot point. No matter what portion
what if they
of
think
the...
If, what if they think it is a major plot point? What if they're... This is what I'm getting at. people are gonna think that we're spoiling something we're not spoiling. So that's why we need to figure out what the generally accepted, not what everybody thinks, but what the generally accepted definition of spoiler is, and make sure we're not doing that. Then when someone comes up to you and says, you know, you shouldn't have said this about this, you totally spoiled the movie. No, it's not a spoiler. This is the generally accepted definition of spoiler. We didn't do that. We want to make sure that we didn't do that. We're not going to ever do that. So
what is the generally accepted?
I don't know. Because I just told you what I think it is, and it doesn't matter what, because you're not going to agree with it.
Well, I don't agree with that definition.
Even what if they took a poll of movie reviewers and 90% said this?
I don't know. Just because you read it somewhere doesn't mean it's true.
You're right. So you don't think that a definition of spoiler exists anywhere in the world?
I'm sure a definition exists.
What would make it a valid definition?
A majority.
Okay.
Yeah, so people that think that.
Majority of reviewers?
No. I don't care about reviewers. I care about people that watch movies.
Okay. So the people say, so they just poll everyone that has ever seen.
I don't know, dude. I don't know how to come up with a better definition.
That's what I'm saying. This is the definition.
I think you have to take every spoiler as it comes and think, am I spoiling this movie?
Well, I think it's a ballpark. I don't think that they say this is a list of things. They say, you know, so if you think that it's a major plot point and it happens at minute 28, so, well, it's not the 30 minutes, so we can say it. I think you're right. We do take every spoiler as it comes, every movie as it comes.
Spoiler's plot specific, I think. Anyway, I don't know, dude. But we weren't even talking about the same stuff, clearly.
But the idea is still the same. I mean, just because what we were talking about that led us up to the spoiler conversation, I mean, I still think if it happens in the first 30 minutes and it's not an obvious, huge, if you know this, it will ruin the movie thing, it's not a spoiler.
Well, then we'll have to talk about each one of those as they come up.
But you don't agree with the whole 30-minute thing. Or 20-minute, whatever the time is.
No, I think that if it's not in the preview...
You can't say it.
You shouldn't talk about it. If it has to do with the plot.
Definition, I think we've spoiled pretty much every single movie we've reviewed.
I know.